Nation, Yali Nation, Yali Nation, good morning. Today we are at the compost pit. We're working on just bringing each pile into another space for it to decompose better. And so we get the manure from the cow shed. We mix it up with dry, you know, dry waste from the farm, either what we've harvested from the field or the remaining from the feed from the animals, the goats, the sheep, the cows, wherever we get the waste from. Then we put it in these boxes, and every 2 weeks, especially on Sundays, we then return them. And so just want to share with you the importance of, you know, taking your work and your passion and your life seriously. I know that sometimes some of us, we think that, you know, things will come by chance, and we often even believe that, you know, that we're lucky. But I don't believe in luck. I believe in hard work, perseverance, you know, consistency in everything you do. And then now the luck is just what other people will say it is, because you get all these blessings that come from it. So you have to always push further than you yourself, you believe you can. And so for let's say, for example, if you feel like, okay, this, I've reached my limit, tell yourself, okay, this is just the limit number one. What is my limit number three? So that then pushes you to want to discover, how far can you go with an idea? How far can you go with a project? How long can you pursue a customer? How long can you pursue a contract? How long can you pursue an investor? Because I remember in my early days, in my early 20s, I had this idea when I was in Senegal that I wanted to do import-export of pineapple from Guinea to Senegal. And even though I didn't know much about the market, I didn't have the contacts, I just saw the opportunity. There's a man I went to talk to, and he was a family friend, very wealthy guy, and I wanted him to invest in my venture. And at that time, I didn't even know how to write a business plan. I didn't know how to write a proposal. I didn't know how to, you know, design a pitch or anything. I just had my ideas and put them on, you know, piece of paper, scraps of piece of paper. And then I send that to him. He looks at it. He doesn't respond. He doesn't call back. I dropped it at his house. It took me about a month to get his number, then another 2 months to find out where he lives. And then by the third or fourth month, I got to meet with him. Then I gave him this proposal written on a scrap of paper. He didn't respond. Then I called and called for another 2 months. He didn't respond. So about 7 months or so, it took of perseverance and calling and consistent that he actually now called me one day and said, okay, come for a meeting. When I came for that meeting, he explained to me that, you know, my idea is premature. I don't have all the information. And I knew he was right. You know, I didn't know at that time, you know, how to start and how to start a very good business, what information you need, what steps you need to take. And so, but one thing he told me, he said, what I like about you is that you don't give up. That's what I like about you, is your perseverance, you know, because I have so many people who come to me, all of them just want my money. So many people come to me just asking for favors. And so I have to shield myself from them. And sometimes that's why I make it very hard for them to reach me, because I want to be sure that this person, whatever they're pursuing, they're taking it seriously. And so you have to understand that everyone who has made it has had to go through those experiences. So you can't just meet someone today and expect for tomorrow for them to give you money, for them to give you their contacts, for them to fall in love with you, for you to be able to build a business with them, for them to invest in your business. That's not gonna happen. If you really want it, you have to be willing to pursue it. You have to be serious about it. You have to push it. You have to go after it every single day. Every single day. Every single day you have to go, as long as it takes until you get it. And so I hope that pushes you for whatever you're pursuing right now, that you don't give up, and know that whoever that person is who's not responding to your emails, your phone calls, you know, that deal that's not going to, keep going after it. If it's worth it, you see, it's worth pursuing. All right? I wish you a wonderful day. Love you very much. Peace out.